biggest cause of death in managed honeybee colonies is the infestation by the ectoparasite Varroa destructor. This might feed on the fat bodies and hemolymph of honeybees, transmitting deadly viruses. However, there is one honeybee that already defeated this mite a long time ago, and today it can live harmonically with this parasite. What can we learn from them? Can beekeepers help the European honeybee with this knowledge? In this video, the video number 2 in this video series, we will start to look at traits already selected on Apsarana, the original host of Varroa mite, and learn how this honeybee species survived Varroa mite parasitism without many problems. Grab your cup of tea, get comfortable, and let's see what the honeybees can teach us today. Hi, I'm Dr. Umberto Boncristiani, and you're watching InsideTheHive.tv, the show about bees. We talk about honeybee research here and how important honeybees are. If you think honeybees are important, please consider subscribing. If left alone, a Varroa mite infestation in managed honeybee colonies of Apis mellifera will kill that colony. Apis mellifera, the European honeybee, is not fully adapted to deal with the infestation of this powerful parasite. As you probably saw in my first video in this video series, about 100 years ago a jumping of species occurred. Varroa mite found Apis mellifera, the European honeybees, for the first time in the old Soviet Union when beekeepers were transporting bees in the region. That was a good deal for Varroa mite that found a new species to replicate on. Different from the original host, Apsarana, Apis mellifera does not have proper defenses in place to deal with the infestation, allowing the mite to replicate much more efficiently, damaging the new host significantly, creating an unbalanced host-parasite relationship. Apsarana, the Asian honeybee, has already passed through this situation in the past. And now, after thousands of years of natural selection, Apsarana and Varroa mites establish a balanced host-parasite relationship, where the parasite doesn't take from the host too much to the point to kill it, allowing both to survive in nature together. What Apsarana does or have to minimize the damage caused by Varroa mite? In 1987, researchers from the Department of Entomology in California Davis and the Institute of Apicultural Research in China published a scientific article describing for the first time a behavioral and physiological resistant mechanism of the Asian honeybee Apsarana to the ectoparasite Varroa destructor. In this publication, the researchers described that Varroa mite parasitism induced the Asian worker bee to perform a series of cleaning behaviors that effectively removed the mites from the bodies of the adult host bees. These cleaning behaviors, better known as grooming behaviors, consist in the use of legs and mandibles as well as abdomen shaking to attempt to remove unwanted material from the honeybee's bodies. Bees can self-clean themselves or clean other nest mates. Grooming is an important social immune behavior that avoids the spread of pests and diseases. The Asian honeybee did not stop there. Another important observation was that after the grooming behavior, the mites were subsequently killed and removed from the beehive in a few seconds to a few minutes. The Asian honeybee doesn't mess around when the subject is Varroa mite parasitism. On top of grooming, the remotion of mite from the nest, Apsarana honeybees could also rapidly and effectively remove mite-infested brood. But you might be asking yourself, what about the European honeybees, Apis mellifera? Can they do the same to fight Varroa mite? When the researchers look at the frequency of these behaviors in Apis mellifera, they found out the European honeybees are able to perform similar behaviors but with much lower frequency compared with the Asian honeybees. And generally, they fail to remove the mites from both the adult bees and the brood. These were the first honeybee traits correlated with Varroa mite resistance found, giving some directions to beekeepers on where to look for potential genetic traits for breeding programs. But what else Apsarana could teach us about fighting Varroa mites? Well, this is what we're gonna be talking about in our next video. Until then, watch this video right here to know more interesting things about honeybees, support me on Patreon if you see value on these videos, and subscribe to the channel if you feel it's worth it your time. I'm glad you're here, thanks for watching InsideTheHive.tv, the show about bees. See you guys next week.